Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at this letter design. And what we're going to do is make this white stroke see-through and the pattern not. So just the other way around. So currently there's a white stroke and you can't see through it. We're going to start with this from scratch. So I'm just going to move this to the side and let's start new with that letter. I'm going to type it. And the font is already applied, which is chunk 5. And now I'm going to take away the base fill. So just to build this from scratch, using the appearance panel. In the appearance panel, the type is now focus is a text object. And the next thing we're going to apply is a new fill, which is this one. And I'm going to select that pattern. And then next thing we get is a stroke. I'm going to make it red so that I'm going to see it. And another stroke, which is slightly thinner and black. And now you see that this red stroke is centered below the black one. So we need to change that. And I'm going to select Effect Path, Offset Path. And we're going to offset it to the inside using negative values, like so. Okay. So that's it. That's the setup and just turn it white, but actually it doesn't matter. Like so. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do is add a background to that pattern. Now you could just edit that pattern and put a background below it. And that would work for this simple pattern, but it doesn't work for all patterns. So we're going to take a look at that. If you are going to make a pattern out of this, like object, pattern, make, like so, and then make this narrower so that they interact with each other and maybe even overlap. So let's make this like so, and let's select a different offset for this, like so. And now they interact, you see. If we now put a background behind this, like this, and then set the stroke to none, but set a fill, like so. And move this to the background, of course, so arrange, send to back, like so. Then what you can get with these backgrounds is that they hide portions of the design. So that's the whole reason why the stacking in the pattern exists. So let's move them closer together, like so. And then again, select this background, make that smaller. But in this case, you won't be able to stack it in a way that it doesn't hide any of the design. So you see, what you could do is change the stacking order, but something will always be hidden. So this is a case in which adding the background inside the pattern won't help. So just don't. And it's done. Let's take a look at how to get a pattern behind this. And of course, in the appearance panel, what you can do is add a new fill. And the fill gets a color and you have got a background behind your pattern, like so. The next thing, of course, we want the stroke to be see-through so that it punches out the background until it gets to the striped, the gray stripes. So in order to get that, you select that stroke in the appearance panel, go into the opacity, set it to 0, and then the next thing down here in opacity, you turn on knockout group. That's that. If you don't see it by now, what you can always do is to go to view using CPU, because the GPU doesn't really work well with knockout groups. But that's how you achieve this look, and it's still editable, so should you need to exchange that letter, then you just type a new one, and that's that.